Welcome to another edition of our Dan Factoids. In this edition, we'll be discussing an interesting phenomenon called oxygen ear. Keep watching. Oxygen ear is a condition that is most commonly associated with hyperbaric oxygen, where individuals breathe 100% oxygen and therefore the middle ear is filled with 100% oxygen, which is gradually absorbed and can actually cause the tympanic membrane to pull inwards. It is also associated with military diving, which may under certain conditions be done on 100% oxygen for reasons of stealth, because the rebreather units on 100% oxygen don't produce bubbles. The point of the matter is this: the absorption effect of the oxygen, but also the disturbance of the natural equalizing process, as shown by Israeli ENT physician Avi Shupak, has actually shown us that the tendency of the ear to equalize may be impaired after exposure to pure oxygen. Now, what does this have to do with you, seeing you are unlikely to be a military diver or breathe 100% oxygen? Well, if you are decompressing on 100% oxygen as a technical diver, this may be relevant to you. But the more common thing is that if you have flown to a diving destination, or if you are doing several dives a day, the slight additional irritation of the middle ear actually accelerates the absorption of the 20% oxygen that is in the middle ear, and therefore in a sense gives the same effect as oxygen ear. So what we recommend if divers fly to a diving destination is to make sure they equalize when they land, and maybe 4 or 6 hours after they've landed, and certainly before they go to bed. And secondly, that they make sure that they can equalize on the dive boat before they go diving, and regularly, at least once every hour to 2 hours in between dives. What that does is it makes sure that the middle ear does not develop this ex vacuo, which is a fancy name of vacuum phenomenon, which retracts the tympanic membrane and sometimes causes divers to have problems on their second or third dive. So we hope that you found that interesting. The oxygen ear effect will probably not affect you, but the slight irritation of the ear mucosa may. And by simply adhering to these basic recommendations, you can overcome the problems that you might otherwise suffer. Thank you for watching, and keep asking your questions.